This one final question, one of Mitt Romney's most recognizable features, his hair. And of course, leave it to the New York Times to track down his stylist, who says that he's tried to tell Romney to go more natural, but quote, he wants a look that is very controlled. The hair goes with the man, end quote. So what do you think? Is it time for Mitt Romney to let down his hair? And Pete, I don't know if you can answer this question because you don't know anything about it.
Yeah, okay. All right.
Sherry, why don't you start? Your hair is beautiful today.
Oh, well, thank you. I think Mitt Romney looks fine. He's being himself. He's authentic. Look, changing the hair didn't make Hillary Clinton president. Changing the clothes and all those earth tones didn't make Al Gore president. Putting on a army cap or whatever, helmet in the tank, didn't make Michael Dukakis president. I think that Mitt Romney is fine. He shouldn't change a thing. This is who the guy is. It's authentic.
Maria?
No, he should not change his hair. His hair is the only core conviction that Mitt Romney has left. He wouldn't know what to do without it. And I think that people, he himself wouldn't know what to do if he let his hair down, and people wouldn't know who he is. They don't know who he is now. And besides, I heard that he was against the Dapper Dan pomade before he was for it.
I think it's Dapper Dan, isn't that? Now we're going way back. Pete, help us out.
Well, I never know how much people care about what I'm saying, Kira, but I certainly can't imagine they care what I think about Mitt Romney's choice in hairstyles, what with this. I'd like to see a bald Mitt Romney or a bald presidential candidate, but right now, Mitt Romney, I would advise him. He's going with this Grandpa Munster, Paulie Walnuts from The Sopranos look. The American people do not trust male politicians that do not have gray hair. I think you need to go fully gray.